Okay, one of the things that's really cool about this computer is the company is constantly putting out upgrades and enhancements and changes, and you can download those for free and then apply them to your computer. So let me show you what I've got here. I'm going to go into a USB stick that I got on the side, and you'll notice files like this will have the periods there. That file name is actually longer. It's truncated, and it's indicated by these periods. One of the things the new firmware is supposed to fix is the length of the file names on USB sticks or USB drives or whatever you've got hooked to the side there. So we're going to go ahead and apply the latest firmware that is on their website. So let me back out of this. I believe it's under Options, Device Settings, System Information. Now if you look up here, I'm on version 1.3.0, and that's the version that came with my computer out of the box. So we're going to upgrade it to 1.3.2, which you could see it sees on the USB stick. I've already downloaded it. It needs to be in the root of that directory, root directory of the stick that you put in, and you don't want to rename it, otherwise the computer won't see it. We'll go ahead and apply this and hope it works good. Here we go. That's going faster than I thought it was going to go. Okay, looks like the computer rebooted. Got the startup sound. Let's see if it did anything for us. So we'll go into the menu, Options, Device Settings, System Information, and yep, it updated to 1.3.2. It was on 3.0 previously. Let's see if we can access some of our stuff on this USB stick. Look at that. It actually has the whole file name now. Or at least most of it. There's still periods, but it's longer than it was, and it's in a different area. I wonder what the maximum length is and what characters are permitted. I'll have to look that up. But looks like the firmware went successful, and look forward to many more as they update this platform.